Back in the 60s, life was a breeze. No top speed limits, no pollution worries. The fun of open-air motoring in E-types, Cobras, Elans, and of course, the Alfa Duetto. With 60s fashion currently back in vogue, one car company is trying to bring back some of those wistful memories. Ginetta Cars was founded by the Walclip brothers in 1958. Based in Essex, they produce sports and racing cars, very much in the Lotus mould. The classic G4 really established the company during the 60s. While in 66, they produced the first ever mid-engine GT car, the G12. Now the company's in new premises in Scunthorpe. They're still making the 4s and 12s, primarily for export to the Japanese market, while the latest models are the G32, now the convertible or coupe form, and this, the Ginetta G33, which brings some of that 60s fun back into motoring. The Ginettas are all handcrafted by a workforce of 40 that turns out around 150 cars a year. Chassis welded together from steel tubing are clad in fiberglass matting with a bonding resin rolled on to form the shape of the body shell. Cars are built in batches of 5 or 6, and once it's been made to fit, the body is mounted on the chassis and then taken to the spray shop to receive 7 coats of paint. Next comes the bolting on of the running gear, with engines and gearboxes bought in from Ford or Rover. The final touch is the fitting of trim and upholstery before the cars are either gift-wrapped for Japan or ready to drive away, and the G33 just has to be the one for me. Not only does it look right, but it sounds right. The whole point is that you don't have to go fast to have fun. Take a winding country lane, a sunny day, and sit behind the long, curvaceous bonnet of the G33. Relax, cruise, and dream. While the latest supercars from Honda and Lamborghini become more and more anaesthetized, the G33 provides raw enjoyment at modest speeds. But don't get the wrong impression, the Ginetta will get up and go from 0 to 60 in 5 seconds, the top speed in the region of 150 miles an hour. Not easy to test those claims. We just happened to be close to Cadwell Park, and it just happened to be free.
Out on your own on a nice summer's day, the G33 really is a delight to drive. It's great fun. It really does bring that feeling of enjoyment back into motoring. The engine sounds good, and the car feels right. Of course, the suspension is fairly stiff. You can feel every pothole through the rear wheels just underneath your slim seat. But you don't really mind that when you're in this sort of car. The actual handling of the car is very good. It maybe turns in a bit too well. It's a little bit pointy with the rear end squatting down under power. Braking, very good indeed. The brakes bring the car down to speed without any fuss at all. Changing gear, up through the gearbox, a pleasure to use, and that lumpy tone of the engine, all the time growling away behind you.
Whilst the car is great fun to drive, Ginetta may just have a little way to go in terms of driver comfort. The seats are not that well padded, the pedal layout is not that good, especially if you've got size 10 feet like mine. But then these cars are still in the early days of production, and Ginetta is the sort of company that will tailor each car to individual owners.
Well, there's no doubt the Ginetta is a lot of fun out on the road. What about the interior equipment? Well, the dashboard really reflects its racing pedigree. A good layout of speedometer, rev counter, oil pressure gauge and water temperature. The wipers and headlamps come on normal stalks. Apart from that, there's not a lot else. There's 3 buttons in the centre, 1 fog lamp, 1 front windscreen demister and 1 for the fan. But then there's the very basic heater control. Not too sure of some of the interior design. Apart from that, precious little else. Mind you, the air conditioning's free.
Pop-up headlamps are neatly hidden in the front wings, but pop up the boot lids
and you'll find limited space. This has to be shared by the soft top frame under the humps that only leaves room for the smallest of bags, while most of the space in the boot proper is taken up by the 9-gallon fuel tank with its filler cap tucked away well inside. Something I last saw on an old Lotus 7. Under the bonnet, the 3.9-litre Rover unit is very easily accessible if the enthusiast wants to work on his car. But this large one-piece hood, the fit is rather showing its sort of kit car heritage, if you like. While the build quality may not be a match for the likes of Honda or Lamborghini, you care not a hoot while the sun shines. But you can't always trust the British weather. So what's it really like? Well, if you're worried about leaks, drafts, the odd rattle and only basic comfort, then the G33 may not be ideal for you. On the other hand, if you've got £18,000 to spend on sheer motoring satisfaction and enjoyment, this just could be the car you've always dreamed of.